Hello, I am Lakshman Maheshwary, and today we are going to talk about a very current and very important issue, which is one nation, one election. So what is a simultaneous election? It is a proposal to conduct the elections to the Lok Sabha and the state assemblies all at the same time. Let us have a look at the recent events. This issue was brought to discussion by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in 2016. Further, an all-party meet was held on June 19, 2019 to explore the possibility of simultaneous elections. Several regional parties gave the meeting a miss, while others used the meeting to bargain a better deal with their states in return for support of one nation, one election. Before that, the Law Commission submitted a draft report to the government on August 30th, 2018, which endorsed the proposal. The Law Commission even recommended the changes to the Constitution and the Electoral Law so as to enable holding simultaneous polls. Before we move any further, let us talk about the current scenario. What happens right now? Currently, elections to the state assemblies and the Lok Sabha are held separately. That is, whenever the incumbent government's five-year term ends or whenever it is dissolved due to various reasons. This is applicable to both the state as well as the national legislature, that is Lok Sabha. Hence, the terms of legislative assemblies and the Lok Sabha may not synchronize with one another. For instance, Rajasthan faced elections in late 2018, whereas Tamil Nadu will go to elections only in 2021. So why is this a problem? According to the Niti Aayog, in the last 30 years, there has not been a single year without an election to either a state assembly or to Lok Sabha or even both. Now let us see what would happen with one nation, one election. Instead of having several elections happening across the country every year, elections will be held only once in 5 years. This will be either in a single phase or more practically in multiple phases. The voters will cast their vote for electing members of the Lok Sabha and the state assemblies on a single day at the same time. This would also require extension in term for some, while reduction for others, at least to begin with. But this is not going to be an easy task. The initiative will need a constitutional amendment, which will have to be ratified by 50% of the states. There are a couple of options. One, which is perfect synchronization, that is, elections will be held once every 5 years. The other can be synchronization in two batches. This makes election across the country synchronized in such a manner that they will be held twice every 5 years. Now let us talk about the background of the issue. Let me tell you right off, simultaneous elections are not new to India. They have been conducted for the Lok Sabha and the state assembly simultaneously in 1952, then again in 1957, 1962, and 1967. Basically, they were the norm until 1967. But following dissolution of some state legislative assemblies in 1968 and 69, and then that of the Lok Sabha in December 1970, elections to the state assemblies and parliament have been held separately. Also, the idea for reverting to simultaneous polls was mooted in the annual report of the Election Commission in as early as 1983. The Law Commission's report also referred to in 1999. However, the final decision on holding simultaneous elections is yet to be taken. Now let us talk about the advantages of one nation, one election. It is believed that the cost of conducting elections will come down since the personnel required to conduct elections will be brought down too. Although, initially, it would mean that the Election Commission of India would need to buy more EVMs, but in the long run, the cost will even out. More importantly, this will help elected governments and the ruling parties to focus on governance instead of preparing for elections somewhere or the other in the country and being constantly in the election mode. This point would apply more to the national parties than to the regional parties. A very important point is that the impact of black money on the voters will be reduced as all the elections will be held at the same time. There is also the thought that the efficiency of the government would increase. If the elections are not conducted annually, then the government need not woo the general public through lucrative schemes and make caste and religion-based programs. Even the states and central government need not prepare lucrative budgets every year, and they can take tough decisions for the betterment of the economy. It is also believed that it will stop policy paralysis because of the model code of conduct being in place multiple times in the 5 years tenure of the government, whether it is the central government or the state government. Law Commission also believes that simultaneous polls will boost voter turnouts as they might have to come only once to vote for both the central and the state legislature. But this is not going to be an easy task. There are a lot of constitutional issues. Article 83 and 172 of the Constitution guarantees 5 years to every elected Lok Sabha and State Assembly respectively. Unless sooner dissolved, this portion will have to be amended. Further, Article 85 Section 1 and Article 174 Section 1 stipulates that the intervening period between the last session of the House of the People or State Legislative Assembly and the first session of the subsequent House or the Assembly shall not exceed 6 months. Simply put, this says that there cannot be a situation where there is no government for more than 6 months. So what will happen if there is a hung assembly or a parliament situation? What will happen if a government falls due to a no confidence motion? What if a representative dies 1 year into their tenure? Will we wait to conduct the elections till the next synchronized period? Let us also talk about Article 356, which deals with president's rule. Article 356 comes into force only if there is a failure of constitutional machinery in a state. Will we use Article 356 just for the sake to have synchronized elections? The Representation of People's Act of 1951 will also have to be amended to build in provisions for stability of tenure for both parliament and assemblies. In the Representation of People's Act, a definition of simultaneous elections would need to be added. The 10th schedule of the Constitution, which is the anti-defection law, will also have to be reconsidered for the sake of stability at the central as well as the state level. Now let us talk about a few of the concerns which have been raised for One Nation, One Election. The first and foremost is the sheer size of the nation and its population. Conducting an election this massive at such a scale will be a real challenge. It is also believed that simultaneous elections may go against the federal structure of the Constitution. It might force the voters to think at a national level, and the state issues or the state concerns may be sidelined. Simultaneous elections can also pose a threat to the regional parties or the new and upcoming parties, since they will have to contest at various states and the central level at the same time. They might be pressed thin for resources and manpower to fight such a massive election. There is also a concern that amending Article 174 and Article 356 will alter the basic structure of the Constitution and will be a threat to the federalism. People believe that dilution of the 10th schedule, the anti-defection law, will lead to horse trading. Further, in this era of coalition politics, it might not be feasible to dissolve the assemblies of the entire nation and the center just because one assembly gets dissolved. This can increase the negotiation, or let us say, the blackmailing power of the coalition partners at a phenomenal level. Now, one very interesting concern is, if the elections are held only once in 5 years, it will reduce the government's accountability to the people. See, the thing is, repeated elections keep the politicians on their toes. They'll have to keep going back to the people. But if the elections are held only once in 5 years, they will not have to worry about the people for the next 5 years. Another very important concern is, when an election in a state is postponed until the synchronized phase, president's rule will have to be imposed in the interim period in that state. Now, there is no saying how long can this period be. It might be just for a couple of weeks, days, months, or it can even go on for, let us say, an year or two. If there is a presidential rule for such a long period, this will be a blow to the democracy and the federal structure in the country. Now, let me give you some examples of one nation, one election in implementation. Worldwide, this is seen in Sweden, Indonesia, South Africa, Germany, Spain, Hungary, Belgium, Poland, Slovenia, and Albania, to name a few. So before I wrap up this video, I would like to hear your thoughts. Please leave your comments in the comment section. Thank you very much. Enjoy your day.